Introduction to Cerebro for a task assignee. In this video, we are going to look at how to get started with Cerebro, installing the program, and starting the first task. For a regular company employee, the work with Cerebro starts when the system administrator creates for them a personal account. After that, the employee receives an email with their account credentials, a login, and a password. The message also contains brief instructions on how to install and run the Cerebro client program. To install the desktop version of Cerebro on a computer, click the link in the message to go to the download section on cerebrohq.com and download the installer for your operating system. When the download is complete, run the installer and follow the instructions of the installation wizard, where you can specify the installation directory or create a Cerebro shortcut on your desktop. In the download section, you may also find links to installers of the mobile version of Cerebro. To install it, open a browser on your mobile device and go to the download section on cerebrohq.com. In the mobile version subsection, click Android or iOS, depending on your device. This will take you to the Cerebro mobile app in the App Store. After you download and install the app from the store, you will see its startup icon on your home screen. Now you can log in to the Cerebro system with your credentials from your mobile device. When you install the desktop version and launch it for the first time, the Cerebro login window will appear. Enter your login or email address and password from the email. You can also access additional savings to select the interface language and tick the following checkboxes if necessary. Remember me to avoid having to re-enter your password or log in automatically to launch the program without showing the Cerebro login window. When you click the login, the Cerebro home screen appears. A slider divides it into two sections, tabs with tasks on the left and forum for the selected task with links and other attributes on the right. You can access your account profile settings from the main menu. Here you can upload an image to use as your avatar, change your email address, or log in, set a more user-friendly password, and configure the alert and email notification settings. The main tab on the left of the home screen is Navigator, which shows the task tree for your company's projects. The subtask tree in the Navigator has unlimited depth, with the messaging feature in the task forum available at each nesting level. Although most of the messaging and file sharing usually happens at the lowest level of basic tasks. Each task and each message have their own unique address with Cerebro, which can be seen and edited in the address bar on the top panel and inserted as a link in forum posts. You can also use an online link to a message that can be shared via email, messengers, or social media. By clicking this link, you will launch Cerebro and see the corresponding task in a message. To start working on a specific task, first you have to find and select it in the Cerebro system. You can do it from the Navigator window by viewing the task tree. For that, you must be designated as the assignee in the task attributes. The same can be done from a different view in the Execute tab, where employees' personal tasks are listed, i.e., all tasks they have been assigned. Unlike the Navigator, the Execute screen does not display a task tree, but a single-level list, which can be sorted, for example, by the task status or by the planned start date. You can select the task you need directly from the list. Since all task views are synchronized in Cerebro, you can select a task in any tab, and all the other ones will switch to it as well. On the right-hand side of the home screen, you will see the task forum with task-related messages, comments, and files, as well as the task status changes. The forum messaging feed always starts with a task description message, which specifies what needs to be done. If you go to a task forum with a long message history, it will only show the first and a few of the most recent messages, while the middle of the feed will be collapsed. You can click it to collapse or expand individual messages, or use the context menu to collapse, expand all the messages at once. For more visual clarity, you can adjust the font size of forum messages and change the size of thumbnails to media files. The first step is to fully understand the task. You can take the task from Cerebro and save it to your computer along with the files attached to the first message. If the name of the attached file is displayed in a white font, then the file can be opened directly from your computer. In this case, double-clicking it will launch the built-in or external viewing software. If the name is in a red font, you must first download the file to a local directory before it can be viewed. Depending on the settings of the Cerebro file storage and whether you work from your company's local network or remotely, newly posted files may be immediately available for viewing, or you may have to download them first. Before getting started, you need to switch the task status to in progress to signal the supervisor and other employees that the task is already underway. At this point, you no longer need Cerebro to work on the task. You will only need to open it again to write a report on the task you have completed. To do so, you need to go back to the task in Cerebro and reply with the report. You can do it by clicking the reply button on the previous forum message or the toolbar at the top of the tab. In this message, you will need to verbally describe what exactly you have done and, if needed, attach the resulting files. You can write the message body in the upper part of the editor window, while the attached files will be displayed at the bottom. These may be, for example, images, videos, or any other files. You can use sidebar buttons to add a single file, several files, or a zip archive, add links to files or folders, or insert the contents of the clipboard as an attachment. You can also drag and drop files or folders in the Cerebro window directly from File Explorer. In this case, two options will appear in the editor window: to add files to the message as attachments or as links. Report messages must include the number of hours it took you to complete the task. They will be added to your personal statistics, as well as the general statistics for the task and the entire project. Before posting the report, you should change the task status to pending review to notify the supervisor that the task has been completed and you are waiting their evaluation and comments, if any. When you click the send button, the message is posted on the forum, the task status changes, and the attached file uploads to the Cerebro file storage. The response will appear in the task forum as the supervisors review.